call him because I wanted to.
Okay, bro.
Hare Krishna, Prabhu.
Oh, we were just calling you, Prabhu. We don't want to miss you.
Hare, actually, some problem, so I have to re-log in. So it took time.
Oh, okay. But Prabhu, we are all geared up. Sudarshan Prabhu was jumping for the opportunity. But yeah, thank you, Sudarshan Prabhu, for your enthusiasm. So we'll give you a chance. Thank you. Okay, Sudarshan, Sadashivan Prabhu, go ahead.
Yes, Prabhu. Hare Krishna. Jaya Radha Madhava.
Keep the microphone a little closer, Prabhu. That's okay.
Kunja Bihari. Jaya Radha Madhava. Kunja Bihari.
Jaya Radha Madhava. Kunja Bihari.
Jaya Gopi Jana Vallabha. Girivarahari.
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 Yashoda Nandana Braja Jana Randana.
Yashoda Nandana Braja Jana Randana.
Yashodanandana Braja Jana Randana.
Yashodanandana Braja Jana Randana.
Yashodanandana Braja Jana Randana.
Yashodanandana Braja Jana Randana.
Yamuna Tira Vanachari.
Yamuna Tira Vanachari.
Jaya Radha Madhava Kunja Bihari.
Jaya Radha Madhava Kunja Bihari.
Murali Manohara Karuna Sagara.
Murali Manohara Karuna Sagara.
Murali Manohara Karuna Sagara.
Murali Manohara Karuna Sagara.
Govardhana Jaya Govardhana Hari.
Jaya Govardhana Giridhari.
Jaya Radha Madhava Kunja Bihari.
Jaya Radha Madhava Kunja Bihari.
Hare Krishna,
Hare Krishna,
Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
हरे कृष्ण प्रभु जी, हरिनाम संकीर्तन की जय। अनंत वैष्णव कोटि वृंद की जय। शिल प्रभुपाद महाराज की जय।
जय वंडरफुल प्रभु सदाशिव प्रभु।
थैंक यू सदाशिव प्रभु फॉर लीडिंग अस इन टुडेस कीर्तन। एक्चुअली प्रभु वेटेड फॉर यू व्हेन यू आर नॉट देयर। प्रभु सपोज टू कॉल यू।
एक्चुअली सदाशिव प्रभु द नेम इटसेल्फ द पोटेंसी इज देयर द शिव तत्व एंड दैट ही इज ऑलरेडी
दैट नेम। आई एम नॉट लाइक दैट डिवोटी, इट्स ओनली मिसइंटरप्रेटिंग माय नेम।
नो प्रभु, दैट नेम आल्सो विल रियली गिव दैट पोटेंसी। सो थैंक यू प्रभु जी। हरे कृष्ण।
थैंक यू।
Chanting is going to lead us by Dr. Lata Mataji today. Mataji, can you hear me?
Yes, Hare Krishna Prabhu.
You can go ahead, Mataji.
Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhara Shiva Sahaja Gaurav Bhakta Vrinda. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Rama Rama.
Keep your microphone little closer, Mataji. I know you might be in some other place, but if possible, keep the microphone little closer. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna,
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare
Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram,
Hare Krishna,
Hare Krishna,
Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare,
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna,
Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare,
Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare,
Thank you, Mataji. Thank you for leading us in today's chanting. We know that, we come to know that you are traveling, but for like such a dedication you showed, really very nice, Mataji. Very inspired by you.
Thank you, Mataji. Very nice.
Thank you, Mataji. And Prabhu, before going for a reading, today's reading is going to lead by Vasavi Mataji. Dr. Lata Mataji asked one question yesterday. I missed it. Can I ask now, Prabhu?
Yeah, go ahead, Prabhu. Let's address.
Actually, Mataji has asked that soul size of the soul, we define that it's 1/10,000 part of tip of the air. From where we find it, Mataji asked it. From where we come to know that?
Yeah, you tell, Prabhu.
this has already answered to Mataji. Actually, this has come from Vedas. Actually, Vedas has directly, we have taken this from Supreme Personality of Godhead. That is the source for us. That is a perfect knowledge that we got from Supreme Personality of Godhead.
Yeah. So they, as Gurudev Prabhu mentioned, we have three ways to gain knowledge. I think most of you know. Sudarshan Prabhu, what are the three ways to gain knowledge? Anybody? Shiva Agarwal Mataji?
From Masterless Marjan Prabhuji.
In general.
Jashit Prabhu raised his hand.
Jashit Prabhu, go ahead.
Anuman Praman, Shabda Praman and Pratyaksh Praman.
Okay. So why we should, which is the best one to gain knowledge from? Which is the best?
Shabda Praman.
Why?
Shabda Praman means hearing, and hearing from trustful source or hearing from God.
Right. Why it is supposed to be the best way, and that is the only way to gain knowledge in definitely from for the spiritual or for that matter material also. For material knowledge or spiritual knowledge, you can depend on the Shabda Praman. Why is that? Why not any other way like Pratyaksha Praman and Anumana Praman are not the right ways? We are not saying that they are totally useless, but at the same time, it is not the best way to gain knowledge. The best way is Shabda Praman only. Well, why is that? Yeah, Sudarshan Prabhu, go ahead.
Because Shabda Praman is the only way, because the evidence which is seen cannot be last for long, last long time, Prabhuji. For example, some people saw Gandhiji, but they cannot describe him, Prabhuji. But if it is written in evidence, it will be true proof, Prabhuji.
Okay.
So that Shabda Praman is the original way.
You are there, but not quite there. Okay, so can somebody give much more precise answer? Malati Mataji, go ahead.
Prabhu, whatever the scriptures, Vedas we have, that from that scriptures we can read only. We cannot see or we cannot imagine. So from that Vedas, we can directly hear and understand.
Okay.
So might be in that way, hearing is more.
Still that why has not been addressed. Why Shabda Praman is the only way? What are the pitfalls in the other two methods? Can you tell? Then automatically you know that this is the best way. What are the pitfalls of the previous other two? Yeah. So, yeah, Snehal Chopade Mataji.
Snehal Mataji raised her hand.
Yeah, yeah.
Hare Krishna Prabhuji. I think the knowledge is come from Guru Shishya Parampara. That's why this is correct.
Yes, yes, that is correct. But what are the pitfalls in the previous other two methods also? If you know, then you will really appreciate Shabda Praman. That is what I am wanting. What are the pitfalls of the previous other two? So, yeah, the Ramesh Prabhu. So Snehal Mataji, but your husband, what's his name, Mataji? Girish? What is his name?
No, Sudhir.
Sudhir. Sorry, Mataji. Sudhir probably has not come today.
No.
Okay. Please invite him for tomorrow session if time permits.
Yes, Prabhuji.
Thank you. Okay. So Ramesh Prabhu, last one. After that, Jessica.
Hare Krishna Prabhuji, Supreme Side. Actually, I want to, I am very new here in ISKCON and in this class also. I think this is the first time I'm joining.
Oh, your name, Mataji?
Supriya.
Oh, Supriya. Okay.
Yes.
Welcome to this group, and we really wanted to welcome you with three Haribols. Hare Bol,
Hare Bol, Hare Bol, Hare Bol,
Hare Bol, Hare Bol, Hare Bol.
Please go ahead, Mataji.
I just want to add to the question which you have asked. So I'm not talking from the scripts from the sculptures or Vedas, but as per my understanding, little understanding what I can understand, I think knowledge is something people are, I mean, Prabhuji's and Mataji's are saying here, that listening. So listening is not something, because we listen in a day or in a minute, we listen so many things, so many voices, but it comes to complete and concrete when we experience it. So I think listening and experiencing it, both the combination of both, is your answer, I think.
Okay, you have a very good point. Actually, when I was also studying when I was doing my master's degree, etc., or in my childhood also, they used to say that to remember things, you should engage more the senses that you can engage, the more retention it would be. See, why when you go to a movie, why is that you are attracted? Why is that you are so interested? Why you remember those things much better? Because more than one senses are getting involved. You are able to see, you are able to hear, you are, etc., etc. And when you are reading also, when somebody is reading to you, you hear, and when you see, you are really seeing with your eyes, you are hearing with your ears. And when you are writing, your touch, and you are concentrating so many other senses also. So retention is more. So that anyways, we agree. But yeah, here we are talking about why is that the other ways of gaining knowledge, especially the Shabda Praman, is the only best way, we are saying. But what are the defects of the previous other two ways of gaining knowledge? Which is what? The first one is direct pratyaksha praman. What I see, then I believe. And the second one is anumana praman. Anumana praman meaning inference. Based on some inference, I do some calculation, or I do some based on my previous knowledge, I conclude, oh, this is what it is, so then this is what it is. So based on some predictions or some kind of a analysis I do, then I conclude. So what are the defects of the other two? So we will conclude now. Oh, Behara Prabhu, we are done with Behara Prabhu. Probably we'll get the answer here. Thank you, Supriya Mataji, for giving the answer.
I want to answer one line more on sure. this. Sorry, because out of curiosity, I want to answer.
Please, you can talk whatever time you want. Sure.
Yeah, so yeah, you are saying the Pratyaksha Praman, right? When we see, when what we see is not always correct. So what we see, that the grass is always greener on the other side. So maybe the grass is not green, right? So Pratyaksha Praman cannot be true all the time.
Right.
So, yes.
So you really got the point. Very, very well said. That is the one of the answers. Definitely yes. That is one of our defects. See, you know that in physics also, when you put a scale in water, the scale looks like it has broken or it is curved. But actually, it is not. Similarly, there are so many that you see in a concave mirror or a convex mirror, you look distorted, but it is not. So a lot of things what your senses are telling you, what you see is not always correct. So that is not the best way to gain knowledge. So that is the one. What is the defects with the Anumana Praman? Thank you, Mataji, Supriya Mataji. That's very well done with respect to what you see is what is not going to be always correct. So it's not the right approach. So Pratyaksha Praman. What is Anumana Praman? What are the defects with Anumana Praman? Anyway, Behara Prabhu. Let's take Behara Prabhu, then because...
Hare Krishna Prabhuji.
Hare Krishna Prabhuji.
These four defects are, first, our senses are imperfect. And we commit mistakes. We get illusion, and to hide that, we try to cheat other. That is called cheating property.
Fantastic. Okay, so finally, you just made all of us dumb. Okay, thank you, Prabhu. Behara Prabhu, you got the answer. So please remember, actually, it is always we learn from each one of us. And Behara Prabhu rightly mentioned that these are the four defects which are there with each one of us. So whatever it is coming from us, suppose I write a book and these four defects will be there. So you cannot trust me. So then you can say that Vedas also have been written,
So are there no defects with that? One last question and then we'll take this reading, Prabhu. So are there no defects? Yeah, somebody raised their hands. Those who have not answered, one last and we'll conclude. Sorry, Prabhuji. Govardhan Prabhu, we'll just take one. Why? If somebody has written Vedas also, so why the same four defects what Behra Prabhu mentioned would also be there in that? Is it not? Yeah. Yes.
Ramesh Prabhu.
We'll go with Jashit Prabhu. Yes, Jashit Prabhu. Then Ramesh Prabhu.
Prabhuji, because Vedas is said directly by God, so it cannot be wrong.
Okay. Yes. Oh, thank you. All of us have raised their hands because that's what it is. See, the Vedas are said to be apaurshaha. Apaurshaha means not written by any human beings. It is written by a superhuman. Superhuman meaning it is written directly from, it has come from the Supreme Lord. It has come to Brahma and Brahma, from Brahma, all this knowledge and basically all the Veda knowledge has been given by Krishna to Brahma and also instructed and given this knowledge about the Vedas also. He not only gave Vedas, but also gave knowledge about the Vedas. And then all this rest of the disciplic succession has taken it from there. Thank you very much, Govardhan Prabhu, for giving this opportunity to discuss on this topic. If anybody has any other questions, please do not hesitate. We will take 1 or 2 or 5, 10 minutes more, but still we wanted to clarify your doubts. Just going with the syllabus is not going to be good enough. Your clarification should be there. Malati Mataji raised her hand. You wanted to add anything, Mataji? Malati Mataji?
I have a doubt, Prabhu.
Yeah, go ahead, Mataji.
Previously, Prabhu told that our senses are imperfect. So that's one of the four mistakes we have, right. Defects we have. So hearing with our eye, that is also, sorry, hearing with our ear is also one of the senses. So hearing can be a defect. So some people hear in a wrong way.
Yes.
So how can it be perfect? That shabda,
that is that is the very good question, and that is the reason why we are discussing today's topic, importance of a guru.
okay, sir.
If I have a Bhagavad Gita book with me and and I am alone, so me and Bhagavad Gita, is that good enough?
No.
That is the whole question. Very well asked and very, very important question you have put. The importance of guru we'll know now. Because everybody has got Bhagavad Gita in their hands. Then will they be really spiritually enlightened? Is it possible? What is the role of a guru? So that is very, very important. This is not a mundane subject matter. For that matter also, you need a guru. But for spiritual subject, undoubtedly, guru's role is very, 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 very important. Okay, thank you, Mataji. Wonderful question. Thank you. Go ahead, Prabhuji.
Thank you, Prabhu, for enlightening us with such a great knowledge. And I hope Dr. Lata Mataji question is addressed properly. And I request Vasavi Mataji to lead us in today's book reading.
Hare Krishna, Guruji.
Hare
Krishna. What is the guru?
Go ahead, Mataji.
Okay, Prabhuji. What is the guru? In all the Shastras, that is scriptures, the guru is described to be as good as God. But the guru never says, I am God. The disciple's duty is to offer respect to the guru just as he offers respect to the God. But the guru never thinks my disciples are offering me the same respect they offer to the God. Therefore, I have become God. As soon as he thinks like this, he becomes a dog. Om Ajnana Timirandasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chakshur Militam Yena Tasmai Sri Gurave Namaha. I was born in the darkest ignorance, and my guru, my spiritual master, opened my eyes with the torch of knowledge. I offer my respectable obediences unto him. The word ajnana means ignorance or darkness. If all the lights in this room immediately went out, we would not be able to tell where we are or others are sitting. Everything would become confused. Similarly, we are all in darkness in this material world, which is the world of tamas. Tamas or timira means darkness. This material world is dark, and therefore it needs sunlight or moonlight for illumination. However, there is another world, a spiritual world, that is beyond this darkness. That is described by Sri Krishna in Bhagavad Gita 15.6. Na tadbhasav सयते सूर्यो न सशग्नो न पावनक यद्वान निर्वर्तेन तद्धाम परम मम That adob of mind is not illuminated by the sun or moon, nor by electricity. One who reaches it never returns to this material world. The Guru's business is to, one second, Guruji. The Guru's business is to bring his disciples from darkness to light. At present, everyone is suffering due to ignorance. Just as one contracts a disease out of ignorance, if he doesn't know hygienic principles, he will not know what will contaminate him. Therefore, due to ignorance, there is infection and we suffer from disease. A criminal may say, I did not know the law, but he will not be excused if he commits a crime. Ignorance is no excuse. Similarly, a child not knowing that fire will burn will touch the fire. The fire doesn't think this is a child and he doesn't know I will burn. So there is no excuse, just as there are state laws. There are also stringent laws of nature, and these laws will act despite our ignorance of them. If we do something wrong out of ignorance, we must suffer. This is the law. Whether the law is a state law or a law of nature, we risk suffering if we break it. The Guru's business is to see that no human being suffers in this material world. No one can claim that he is not suffering. That is not possible. In this material world, there are three kinds of sufferings: adhyatmika, adhibhautika, and adhidhaivika. These are miseries arising from the material body and mind, from other living entities, and from the forces of nature. We may suffer mental anguish, or we may suffer from other living entities, from ants or mosquitoes or flies, or we may suffer due to some superior power. There may be no rain, or there may be flood, there may be excessive heat or excessive cold. So many types of sufferings are imposed by nature. Thus, there are three types of miseries within the material world, and everyone is suffering from one, two, or three of them. No one can say that he is completely free from suffering. We may then ask why living entity is suffering. The answer is out of ignorance. He doesn't think I am committing mistakes and I am leading a sinful life. That is why I am suffering. Therefore, the Guru's first business is to rescue his disciple from this ignorance. We send our children to school to save them from suffering. If our children do not receive an education, we fear they will suffer in the future. The Guru sees that suffering is due to ignorance, which is compared to darkness. How can one in darkness be saved by light? The Guru takes the torchlight of knowledge and presents it before the living entity enveloped in darkness. That knowledge reveals him from the sufferings of the darkness of ignorance. One may ask whether the Guru is absolutely necessary. The Vedas inform us that he is.
Mataji, that's where we need to stop today.
Okay, Prabhupada.
Okay. Thank you, Mataji. Vasavi Mataji, can you read the questions also?
And yes, Prabhuji.
Prabhuji, can I read, Prabhuji?
Yeah, Mataji will read the questions. You can answer, Prabhu.
You are
very good in answering questions and also asking questions.
Okay, Prabhu.
From Shloka Om Ajnana Timirandasya, how can one understand what is the business of Guru?
Okay. So please raise your hand. So, Om Ajnana Timirandasya. Ajnana. So, these are really small words, but we need to understand. Om Ajnana Timirandasya. So, what does that mean? Please raise your hands. Those who have not been participating, please participate. There is no right and wrong answers. Muskan Mataji, go ahead, Mataji.
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji. Can you hear me, Prabhuji?
Yes, Mataji. We are ready.
Prabhuji, Ajnana Timirandasya, by this shloka, we can understand that Guru will help us to bring us out from ignorance or darkness in which we are living through a torchlight.
Okay, very nice. Vasavi Mataji, you go ahead. You wanted to say something.
Ajnana means that ignorance, Guruji, and Vimirandasya is that darkness. So the Guru's business is to bring his disciples from darkness to the light, from ignorance to the known things, I mean light. No human being will be suffering in this material world by Guru's words and teachings.
As you mentioned, Mataji, the word Ajnana means ignorance. So basically the Guru's job is to bring us out from this darkness or from ignorance. So that is the Guru's business, right? That is very clear. Now, I'll ask you a side question here. So why should one approach a Guru? Because Malati Mataji rightly asked a question. So we'll also address that. Why one should approach a Guru? Is it required? Because if you see, so yesterday somebody was saying, I think Aishwarya Mataji also, she was saying that Jiddu Krishnamurti philosophy is that somebody has written or read his books, it says that you don't need to follow a Guru. You don't need a Guru. You yourself are a Guru. So, and he convinces you with his jaggery of his words and his whatever analysis he does. And finally, he says that you will be convinced. I don't need a Guru. I am a Guru myself. And this same kind of a philosophy is what others also have got, Mayavadis. You are a Guru. You are a God. You yourself are a God. Why do you need another God? Why do you need an external God? You are a God yourself. This kind of a intellectuals are there who will bombard with whatever they have. But what is wrong? Why should one approach a Guru? What is your personal opinion, Sadashivan Prabhu? What is your personal opinion?
Yeah, my personal opinion, Prabhu, let us for a minute forget about spiritual. Even in material life also, there are so many books available and library is there. We just cannot pass the exam by just reading our own. Okay. That is why teachers are required. Okay, teachers will teach us, then we will understand. Similarly, for spiritual also, we have to approach a teacher. Here, nothing. Teacher is nothing but a spiritual master. Who will guide us, and then we can understand what actually the content is all about.
Right. So, yes, to that extent, I understand. Now, the point is that, suppose we take the example. I am also learning as part of you. Please don't understand that I am somebody who knows a lot of things. I am also learning. So, now my question to you, please correct me. Now, Srila Prabhupada has left this material world. Now, he has given his books. So can I not just read those books and really get enlightenment? Why really? See, the Science of Self-Realization book, we are really realizing a lot of things by just reading a book. Why do I need somebody else now?
Yeah, I see either a Shiksha Guru or a spiritual master is required, because we cannot interpret on our own. We may be wrong sometimes, and okay, we may be misguided ourselves.
Okay, thank you, Prabhu. Ramesh Prabhu, after that, Pooja Mataji.
Yeah, the one whoever takes up this spiritual subject, he is come because he has some confusion in mind first place. And the confusion is compared to the darkness and like the snake and the rope analogy. So one who has already got some confusion here, if he is going to claim himself as I can do it, then he is going to go into a loop of confusion. So basically, only Guru is the one who has already overcome this difficulty and can show the path.
Right. Thank you, Prabhu. Yeah, Pooja Mataji wanted to add. After that, Swati Mataji.
Yes, Prabhuji. So according to me, Guru is somebody who has already experienced whatever learning is there in the book. So if we learn from a person who has already experienced, because he will tell everything out of his own experience. And if we're just reading it, we will imagine something, we might go wrong somewhere. So it's always good to know from the person who already applied those things in his or her own life.
Yes, yes. Acharya is what, that is what we say. Acharya meaning who has practiced in his life, and with his acharan, he is telling you what to do, what not to do, and how to do, how not to do. So that's good. Thank you. Ravi Prabhu, one last, and then we'll conclude this question.
Yeah.
Yeah, Ravi Prabhu is not there. So, yeah, go ahead.
Hare Krishna Prabhuji.
Yeah, after that, Swati Mataji also.
Prabhuji, that gurus are the teachers, preachers. They would have observed something from their guru and they are following it. And we should observe them, then we will follow. Then somebody else will observe us, then they will follow. So it is, they are like a messenger. The true information will come. Otherwise, if we are reading, if I ask somebody from America, what is meant by transmigration, they would not be able to define exactly what exactly is meant by that. So in the same way, a guru is somebody who has really practiced it. And looking at that, we can get into that practice. Yes.
Okay. Aparna Vaidya Mataji wanted to add. Thank you, Prabhu. Thank you very much. Yes, Aparna Vaidya.
Hare Krishna Prabhuji, Dandavat Pranam. All answers are more or less relevant to the question. But one which I have an understanding is that Guru takes all of your sins. He absorbs all your sins as he put you in light. He absorbs your darkness and everything. And he absorbs your sins also. He purifies you. And he prepares you for the God.
Yes. Fantastic.
Importance, what I have an understanding, Prabhuji. Yes. This is the importance of Guru in our life.
Yeah, fantastic. Thank you, Mataji. So I'll just, so please forgive me. I will just conclude this question. First of all, my limited realization. See, the mundane material knowledge that you have, mathematics, physics, chemistry, as Shiva Sadashivan Prabhu said, we also need somebody to teach us there. That more or less is fine, but when it comes to spiritual knowledge, right? This spiritual knowledge, just by reading also, realization doesn't happen. This process is not based on senses. What I mean to say is that just by reading, hearing, you think that you are getting it. But actually, just try to understand this. This is my own revelation and I just heard from somebody else also, authentic source. So what happens is that unless and until you have Guru's mercy, you cannot get this knowledge. You might think that, yes, I have read the 700 slokas of Bhagavad Gita. I am now spiritual. Not going to be happening. Unless and until you have the mercy of the Guru and senior Vaishnavas, this knowledge will not really penetrate. Because this is not material knowledge. This is spiritual knowledge. And the spiritual knowledge will come only from a spiritual being. And that spiritual being, through Guru Parampara and Guru's mercy, that only will come. Those gurus who are not are really there in this material world, still they operate. Still, this cannot be proven by your, question answers kind of a thing by proving. But this is how the knowledge will transfer. The knowledge, spiritual knowledge transfers through mercy. So you have seen a lot many times. See, if you see, the gurus who are there, top frontliner gurus in ISKCON, they were initiated or they had some contact, Maharajas who are now working or who are spreading this Krishna consciousness for last 30, 40 years, they had a glance of Srila Prabhupada for 3 to 4 minutes. There are some who are just had that. And they had just that little contact. And because of the mercy of the Guru, this entire thing, they have taken it on their shoulders and they got the knowledge. The knowledge comes through mercy. So how we should approach a Guru is what very clearly it is mentioned in our Shastra. And it is said that Tadviti Pranipatena Pariprasnena Sevaya. How do you gain this knowledge? See, it is not through our own endeavor that we are talking about we'll get this knowledge. Yes, our endeavor is there. But how that endeavor should go is what is very, very clearly mentioned in Bhagavad Gita 4.34. Where it says that Tadviti Pranipatena Pariprasnena Sevaya. So you have to But you need to surrender to the spiritual master, and then only this knowledge will be imparted to you. And how it will be imparted? When you also ask pariprasnena, with submissive attitude, you are posing or asking questions, then the knowledge will come to you. So the way Arjuna did to get the knowledge, the same way we should also get the knowledge. And we need to and now Srila Prabhupada is not there. So how you can still have that gratitude? And that is the reason whenever we do any kirtana or whenever we are doing any shastra discussion, we first pray to the Guru Parampara. Because unless until that mercy is not there, we cannot really cross over this material existence. And one more sloka is there. Mukam karoti vachalam pangum langayate girim tatkrupa tamaham vande paramananda madhamam. So here it says that those people who are not able to speak, with Guru's mercy, they are eloquently now able to speak. The person who is lame, he cannot even walk, he is able to cross over the mountains. How is that possible? Just because of Guru's mercy. So Guru's role is very, very important. And if not anybody, that is the reason why initially it is mentioned here. But the disciple's duty is to offer respect to the Guru just as he offers respect to God. But the Guru never thinks that my disciples are offering me the same respect they offer to God. Therefore, I am become God. So no, the Guru will not. In turn, this Guru will give all that credit to his Guru. And that Guru will in turn give it to the next Guru. That entire parampara will be given that way, and finally it will reach Krishna. Because Adi Guru, who is Adi Guru? Krishna is the Adi Guru. Okay. Thank you, Lata Mataji. So I think I did discuss this in an elaborate way. So thank you. Probably we need to go for the next question. If not, I'll keep speaking. Any you wanted to add for this, or anything that you have any doubt in this? You can raise. Yeah.
Prabhuji.
Yeah, Sudarshan Prabhu, quick. Go ahead.
Can I add something for this question, Prabhuji? Prabhuji means Guru is a person who sees that a person does not suffer with anything, Prabhuji. Means there are three sufferings in this world, like Adhyatmika, yes, Adhivatika, yes, and Adhidei.
That is the next question. So we will see that. Next question. Yeah, go ahead, Prabhu.
From today's module, please discuss.
Okay, Dr. Lata Mataji wanted to speak something. Prabhuji, can I speak once? Yeah, Dr. Lata Mataji, go ahead. She sent a message. Okay, in the end, Lata Mataji wanted to speak. Okay, thank you. So, second question, please. Mataji.
From today's module, please discuss why it is said that no one claimed that he is not suffering in this world. Please discuss various types of suffering with the examples.
Okay, yeah. So, what about others? I wanted to see that others also. Shiva Agarwal Mataji, you are not speaking. Okay, others? Puja Mataji, Preeti Mataji, Muskan Mataji, Simran Mataji, Supriya Mataji, you have anything? Yeah, if not, we'll give chance. Go, Gordon Prabhu, coordinate please. Whom you wanted to get?
Sudarshan Prabhu is regularly asking. We'll give chance first. Sir.
Yes.
Sudarshan Prabhu, quick Prabhu. So, Sudarshan Prabhu, you want to answer?
Our second question, Prabhuji.
Yes, Prabhu.
Okay, Prabhuji. Prabhuji, there is a... Prabhuji, I did not understand the second question properly, okay, Prabhuji. Okay, can you explain the question properly, Prabhuji?
Can I say?
Yeah, go ahead. Yeah,
Mataji. Yeah, no one can claim that he is not suffering. That is impossible. That is not possible.
Okay.
In this material world, three kinds of sufferings are there: Adhyatmika, Adi Bhauktika, and Adi Daivika. These arise from material body and mind.
Yes.
And different types, so many types of sufferings are there, and it is imposed by nature. There are three types of miseries, and everyone is suffering from one or the other.
Right. Yes, thank you, Mataji. Was it Usha Mataji?
Yes, Prabhuji.
Oh, thank you, Mataji. After a long time, you are speaking.
Yeah. By the way, congratulations to you, Prabhuji. So many appreciations from so many Prabhuji's and Mataji's for you. Keep it up.
All in your Krishna's mercy, Mataji, and all senior Vaishnava's mercy. I have hardly any knowledge, and just with all your mercy, able to do this seva. That is really, thank you.
No, you have really done a lot, Prabhuji, by clearing the doubts, inspiring everyone.
I am learning a lot from all your association. So it is my, I need to create one video where I need to express my gratitude, and I will do it. Thank you, Mataji.
Hats off to you, Prabhuji.
Thank you, Mataji. So yes, so we'll go ahead with the, so one of the things I wanted to just add here, see, first of all, you will be able to understand, or you will be able to take up Krishna consciousness only when you acknowledge this. This is very important. When you acknowledge that I am suffering here, then only rest of the things will fall into place. If not, you will not really take up this Krishna consciousness, nor any of the process that we are telling here. First, acknowledge or mentally, or at least understand that you are suffering here. Some people may say that, especially the young people who are just teenagers, they may say that, what is suffering? I'm not suffering. So now they may not be suffering, but down the line they will come with respect to any of these three might get affected. Adibhautika, Adidaivika, Adhyatmika, anything can come to them. But this is inevitable. Suffering is inevitable here. And some people may say that, if you come to Krishna consciousness, will there be no suffering to me? So is that correct? When I get into Krishna consciousness, there will be no suffering to me?
No.
So what?
No problem.
But
no problem.
Lot of religious organizations other than ISKCON says that you come to us, pray with us, and all your misery will be going away. And you just have to put some a donation or come to our association, and our big numbers with our prayers, everything will be possible. You did Krishna anywhere in Bhagavad Gita say this?
No, Prabhu, not at all.
No, Prabhu.
So what what is the guarantee that he is giving? Can you raise your hands? One last question, and we'll go to the last question after this. Yeah. Govardhan Prabhu, one coordination is required here.
Okay, Prabhu. Will you chance to Malati Mataji?
Yes, yes, Malati Mataji, go ahead.
Prabhu, in Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna has given the guarantee that if we do the karma which is offered to him, then only we will reach to him in this life or in many, many other lives.
Okay. And
he also told we should not bother about the results.
Okay, okay, good.
That is what he said.
Right. So
and the sufferings will be there. Sufferings will be there. But he, those people, the devotees who surrender unto him, he will show a little special mercy that he'll take out some of the sufferings for them. But he will not show any partiality to anybody.
Right.
But those who are surrendered to him, he will show some special mercy on the devotees.
Right. Thank you, Mataji. So, as we have seen that the suffering is integral part of this material world, and we will suffer. If not now, some other time suffering is there. Though don't come to this conclusion that I am reading Bhagavad Gita, I came to Krishna consciousness, I am praying Krishna, but still I am getting a lot of these problems in my life. Why? So, whatever quota is there of suffering, you have to bear it. And that is what Krishna says, Sitoshna Sukha Dukkada. So, he says that in this material world, there is ups and downs. There is cold and heat. So all these things of happiness and distress is there. So tolerate, that word he uses is tolerate. So a lot of people, what they do is that they, instead of tolerating, they go into wrong ways of doing things, either to escape from the, instead of tolerating it. So what they do is that they indulge in activities such that they can defocus their mind on something else by taking drugs, going with cultivating vicious habits, woman, wine, all these things. So one has to tolerate, and for to tolerate also, you need Krishna's mercy and Guru's mercy, and very important, association is required. Once you get association, strength will always be built, and your strength will come up through association. So whenever you get association, then you can tolerate these material calamities, whatever issues are coming, you will be able to tolerate. But that is the only way. So last question, Prabhu.
Mataji. Why and how Guru rescue his disciple from suffering?
Yeah. How does Guru really? Yes, please.
If anyone wants to answer, please raise your hands.
Last and final question for today. Yeah, anybody new? Possibly Mataji can answer.
One request before answering. Actually, if you want to add any other points which previous devotee not addressed it, please like raise your hands so that we can save time.
Yeah, we'll quickly move on to the subject matter. Yeah, thank you, Mataji. Vasvi Mataji, you wanted to add anything? It's the same. Okay. So, okay, let's summarize the last point. Why and how the Guru rescues his disciple from suffering? Anybody?
Sudarshan Prabhu, you want to answer?
Yeah, go ahead.
Can I, Prabhuji?
Yes,
that's Prabhuji.
You can go.
Prabhuji, a Guru will rescue his disciple because he is believing him Trikarana Shuddhi, Prabhuji, by heart. Sentence and with heart, Prabhuji, so that he will be rescuing, Prabhuji. And how he will rescue means protecting from Ajnana, Prabhuji.
Okay, good. Thank you, Prabhu. So basically, as we have discussed the entire module, how does the Guru really rescue his disciple from suffering? Basically, by knowledge, he will give you such that you can overcome these sufferings. Okay, and you will be overcoming these sufferings and coming out of the cycle of life and death, because the sufferings are integral part of this material world. So if you cannot, you are brought into a situation where you will not come back to this material world, automatically the suffering will be removed from your quota. So that is what the Guru is going to do. The Guru is basically transporting you to a world where there is no suffering. And where is that there is no suffering? Which is that world? Can somebody tell me which is
Goloka that? Goloka Brindavana.
Goloka Brindavana, or it is called Vaikuntha. Vaikuntha meaning Vaikuntha, where there is no suffering. Kunta means suffering. So Vaikuntha means where there is no suffering. So that is where you will be transported to. And that is what we are all aspiring for. And definitely you will get that, those sufferings are there, you will be unaffected in this world also. Like if you see, a lot of Maharajas who are there now, they are undergoing so many operations and physical issues are there. But still, they are able to overcome because they are operating at a different level. And that is what you will also be able to, because the tolerance is what will be given by Krishna only. See, you think that the tolerance, you are tolerating it. But Krishna is going to give you the necessary things so that you can tolerate the sufferings. And you can overcome this sufferings we have, Adi Bhautika, Adi Devika, and Adi Atmika. And you will be transgressing it. So with that, we end for today. Dr. Lata Mataji wanted to speak in the end. So Mataji, the forum is open to you for discussion or for your whatever inputs you have.
Hare Krishna Prabhuji.
Hare Krishna Mataji.
Prabhuji, sorry, I could not participate in chanting properly because I thought my shift was something else, but at the end my shift changed. So I was from home to hospital. I reached hospital, so somehow I could do. But next time I'll do my best.
Okay. Thank you, Mataji. One thing is that you are committed. That is what is more important. And we are very, very happy. And sometimes it is said that enthusiasm and commitment is infectious. So like that, your commitment and your enthusiasm is really inspiring us. Thank you. With being so, so, so busy, still in office, you have taken this opportunity to talk to us.
Prabhuji.
Mataji, bow down to you. Thank you, Mataji. Thank you, Prabhu.
Prabhuji.
Yes, Govardhan Prabhu.
Yes, Prabhu. Actually, one new devotee, I think, is joined today. SUP, named as SUP. You want to ask some questions? Okay, Supreme Mataji. Supreme Mataji, I want to ask some questions. Mataji, you can go ahead, Mataji.
Yes.
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji. Yeah. So actually, I have a question not related to the subject matter which is going on right now in this session. I have a question related to ISKCON parampara. So is there any Purna Sanyas parampara happens for a woman in ISKCON?
Actually, Mataji, let me address one by one. So women in ISKCON are in, for that matter, from our Vedic perspective, that there is no sannyasa for women. So there is, they don't give sannyasa to women. They are always, as per our Shastra, as per Manu Upa Samhita also, and as per Chandikya Pandit also, women are always should be under the shelter of, when they are like kids, they should be under the shelter of the father. And when they are, when she is married, under the protection of the husband. And after, if husband is not there, she should be under the protection of the their children, especially the their elder son or somebody, or their sons. So, and if sons are not there, their children. So this is how it is there, and they do not have any sannyasa per se for women in ISKCON or in our Vedic system at all. So it is not, and some upper sampradayas have come where people are really going and saying that I am this amma, I am that, and they got sannyas, which is not authentic. This is for my from my understanding, which I feel that is correct as per ISKCON also.
Thank you so much for addressing my question.
Yes, ma'am. Because a lot of misconceptions are there, and people are, see, well, let's understand one thing. If you follow the, see, the entire world is exploitative. I'll tell you, sometimes I'm really blunt, and at the same time, I wanted to put the facts with no sugar coating. So it might look like why this Prabhuji is so unscrutinizingly or harshly speaking. But the point is that if you see the Western society, in the name of liberalization and women emancipation, they have exploited women like anything. I'm telling you, this is, I stayed in US for 6 years for a bottle of beer, a bottle of wine, women are losing their chastity. And they are earning a lot, but what? They are, what is this dating system, nonsense systems that they have propagated, and it is still propagating in our, and what is this living in relationship? What kind of a society is it? Animals are, what is there no culture? So this is in the name of, and who is suffering? End of the day, who is suffering? To be precise, women are suffering. And if you see in the Western society, why cosmetics is so much, it's a big industry there, and they wanted to keep themselves very fit. They wanted to keep themselves slim. Wanted to show themselves that they are beautiful. Because if they are not shown like that, the their boyfriends or their husbands will leave and then choose somebody else. So that is the kind of mentality that people have become, and it is just that sense gratification. So one has to come out of all these and really take the essence of Bhagavad Gita and come out of this first and foremost thing. If you wanted to come out of this mentality, you should really take up three things. As we discussed earlier, I'm elaborating on this. One is that you need to purify your senses. And for that, what you need to do to purify your senses? Anybody?
Chanting. Purify chanting Maha Mantra.
Okay, not get there. Anybody else want to answer? Ramesh Prabhu? To purify your senses, what you need to do?
You need to do Swadhyay.
Okay, so people...
Control the senses.
Yes. Sharda Mataji? Okay. So...
Control the senses, Prabhuji.
Mataji?
It has to be controlled.
Okay. How can you control senses? It is not possible. You need to engage them. So you need to engage them in what? You need to engage them in seva. Whenever you do engage your senses in seva, then only the senses will be purified. So that is the only way. So if you wanted to purify your senses, seva. If you wanted to purify your mind, you need to do what? You need to do your sadhana. So to purify your mind, sadhana. To purify your intellect, you need to do swadhyaya. So we discussed this. I know it is confusing, but just write it down somewhere because our memory is short and you cannot remember. But unless and until you do all the three things, you cannot really get your, you cannot really get your perfection. And you cannot really come out of this life and death, whatever cycle is there. Because there are so many people in the market who will say that come and join our organization, we will give you meditation technique. And meditation technique may take you only one part of it. Maybe it may control your mind. But what about the other two? Your sense purification has not happened. Your intellect purification has not happened. Then again, you will be falling down into this material pool and you will be doing the same nonsense things what you have done earlier. All three is available in Krishna consciousness, and that is the way you can go out. Yes, Mataji. Thank you, Dr. Lata Mataji. Sadhana, Swadhyaya, and basically Seva. Don't forget Seva. Whatever reading you are doing, whatever chanting you are doing here as part of the Seva is all what it purifies. So please take up any Seva. Book distribution is a Seva. And today we are not talking about book distribution score these days, but Riddhi Mataji and Sabita Mataji have done enormous seva in this. I bow down to her and their family and for inspiring us in book seva. And she has crossed, it will not be surprising if she touches 1,000 also, individual score. So that's how she is moving. Thank you, Matajis, and each one of you. Govardhan Prabhu has done his own wonderful score, and Sri Harsha Prabhu has done, and all others also have contributed so well. So please do whatever you want. That seva should be there. Not for any of us. It is for your own sense of purification. So because we are attached to our money, by all these things, we don't want to indulge in any seva activities because still we are keeping with ourselves. So when you do seva, our senses get purified. Thank you, Prabhuji. And Prabhuji. Thank you for asking that question. Thank you.
Prabhuji, I got a query.
Yeah, go ahead, Prabhu.
Yeah, see, one night, now I go to sleep. I feel, okay, I'm a bit feeling Krishna conscious and all that. Morning, I get up, it is all wiped out. That's very strange.
So as I told you, Prabhu, if you don't have anything, what you should have, can somebody tell me what is the first and foremost thing one should have to see what Prabhuji is saying is the problem to each one of us. So ideally we should remember Krishna and not forget Krishna all the time. That's what. And Prabhuji is saying that in the night I am able to remember, but in the morning everything is wiped out. So why is that happening? What I should do? So I wanted to listen from others who who have not been speaking, what you can do? Start thinking. It's not like right and wrong answers. Pooja Mataji, Anil Kumar Prabhu, Preeti Mataji, go ahead, Mataji. What you should do?
Hare Krishna Prabhuji. Early morning, you can get up and do some chanting, Prabhuji. Have a good bath and have a chanting and sit in peace and the calmness in the early morning may definitely help.
That is good, Mataji. But the point what I'm trying to ask you is that why is that we are forgetting? And what will make us to come back to that? Because ideally, you should be remembering Krishna and never forget Krishna.
Can I, Prabhuji?
What we should have?
Can I, Prabhuji?
One second, Prabhu. I am just
thoughts about thoughts about Krishna, reading about Krishna. Even if we are doing our day-to-day activity, like whatever our routine is, whenever we have our thoughts and focus should be about Krishna also.
Okay.
Then so, we will not be deviated and have such things.
Maybe. Yes, Prabhu. Ramesh Prabhu, you yourself tell what would be the way out for this? Because you... what do you think?
Always keep Krishna in the center.
Yes, always keep Krishna in the center. Very well said, Mataji. But that's not easy. That's not for us. It is very difficult. So what we need to do? Is there any easy solution, Supriya Mataji?
Yes, the most easiest solution to think about Krishna or keep Krishna in the center, whatever we do, is just to love. Love everyone because Krishna resides in all soul, in every heart.
Ah.
So, if you love, if you show kindness towards any, irrespective of their anything, caste, money or anything, I mean, don't look into their outer appearance, outer thing. Just look into their soul, into that Atma. So and just love.
That is good, Mataji, from a theoretical, please forgive me, but from a theoretical perspective, that is really good. But how is that going to really transform is not easy. But the, actually, Srila Prabhupada gives a very easy solution to really address Ramesh Prabhuji's question. Sudarshan Prabhu, one last inputs and we'll take up. Yeah, Sudarshan Prabhu.
What? Prabhu means I have a doubt, Prabhuji, not this one.
Okay, you'll ask your doubt later, next after this. Malti Mataji wanted to say, how is that we can address this? One liner.
Practically, some of the examples I can give, Prabhu. So whatever in a day-to-day life, we can remember Krishna, we can see that possibilities.
Okay.
Like posting pictures of it.
Okay.
Associating with the devotees.
I will address this. See, Srila Prabhupada says that if you wanted to remember Krishna and not forget Krishna, always you need association. Association is very important. How you will associate, what you will associate is up to you. Ramesh Prabhu. So this is what is the answer. Answer is that why you are able to remember Krishna in the evening? Because you are associating. And now when other early in the morning, why you are forgetting? Because you are not associating. You need to find out based on your capacity and your time, etc., what you need to do such that you can remember Krishna. Ideally, as a lot of Matajis have suggested and Usha Mataji also mentioned, so you can take up the chanting in the... See, end of the day, you need to do all the three. What is first one is what? You need to do seva, some seva, whatever seva, some seva you do, so senses can be purified. Second is that you need to do some kind of a sadhana such that you can, mind can be purified, such that purified what? See, and the last one is intellect, which has to be done through swadhyaya, study. When we do all the three, so purification happens. Purification happens means what? You will be attaining your original constitutional position. See, it is like a mirror is there, dust is put on the, or dust accumulated on the mirror. So, are we changing anything to see yourself clearly? You just have to remove the dust. But you are not changing yourself anything. You are the same person, but only thing, you are already pure. You are already having Krishna consciousness. You already have this love, what Supriya Mataji said. You are naturally, your position is to love others. and you love everyone, but we are not able to do. Why? Because dust is accumulated. To remove the dust, all three you need to do. Seva, sadhana and swadhyaya. So in an easy way, Srila Prabhupada gave a formula. He gave a formula called A, B, C, D. Can somebody remember what is this A, B, C, D? One last time we'll end today.
Association.
Yes, Mahatma. Anil Kumar Prabhu. Go ahead, Prabhu. Anil Kumar Prabhu.
A for association, B for books, C for chanting, D for guide, E for engagement.
Wow, you went one step ahead. So, thank you, Prabhuji. Anil Kumar Prabhuji's son has spoken that, or daughter?
Prabhuji, this is not only Anil Kumar's friend. This is also somebody else behind it.
Oh, okay, okay. Thank you, Mataji. So we are all happy that your entire family is listening and you are able to contribute. Thank you so much, Mataji. So
it's actually, you, Prabhuji, you, how they got engaged with your classes.
Okay, thank you, Mataji. So please take up some services as part of these activities, like chanting, so reading or any book, anything. So that way we get much more association. Thank you, Mataji.
Thank you, Krishna Prabhuji.
Thank you, Prabhu. So,
Prabhuji, I have a doubt, Prabhuji.
Gordon Prabhu, we have time for one more doubt. What, Sudarshan?
Prabhu, Sudarshan Prabhu, if you don't mind, we will take up your question tomorrow, or else you can write in WhatsApp.
Small, small.
Okay, okay. Go ahead, Prabhu. Yesterday also said the same to he will kill us now. Okay, Sudarshan Prabhu, go ahead.
Prabhuji, they given a small notice in group that we need to submit our residential address, na Prabhuji. What is for that, Prabhuji?
Gordon Prabhu, you wanted to address that?
Yes, Prabhu. Actually, those like. From our temple management, we got an information that from the devotees, if you collect addresses, they want to send us greeting and if possible, they will send prasad also. For that, we are collecting address.
Is that having any fair, Prabhuji?
No, Prabhuji. We will do it from our side.
Yeah, so basically, the, as a token of appreciation from ISKCON Hyderabad, we wanted to send some things to you. The temple management, that includes prashad, etc., whatever the management decides. So please give your addresses. And
for whom we need to submit, Prabhuji?
The form is already there. If you have difficulty, just send it to me. I will, or to Gordhan Prabhu, or Sanda, any of us, that is good.
Okay, Prabhuji.
Okay, thank you. So no other questions, then we'll end for today. So, and thank you once again, Supriya Mataji, for asking such wonderful questions, and Usha Mataji for addressing so many nicely, so many things. And Anil Kumar Prabhu, thank you again for your entire family and all Matajis and Prabhujis for giving this opportunity. One last input I have, our announcements per se. On 25th, we wanted to do this chanting of 108 slokas. Reciting the 108 slokas. So those who have not yet volunteered to read certain some of the slokas, whatever, you can practice at least few slokas and then come. So that way we are also getting associated and but giving your own seva. So that is one thing. Second thing is that on 25th morning, if you all permit and with you all can come, 6:30 we can start our chanting until 1 hour we can do the chanting. But like basically we do that every day. So you at least once you can also join and you can do this chanting. And those who cannot spend so much time, you can just exit out in the in between or in the middle also.
Prabhuji.
On 25th is a holiday. Holiday, Christmas holiday, right? So,
yes. Prabhu, 16 rounds chanting, Prabhu.
We are targeting Mataji, but let us see, 6:30 to 7:30. In 1 hour, we may not be able to complete all 16 rounds, yes. But whatever we can. And if people wanted to extend, we will see. But ideally, at least 1 hour, we are thinking that we should do the chanting on 25th. So,
Prabhuji.
Yeah.
Are there any person in Tirupati to assist us, Prabhuji, ISKCON?
ISKCON, you can go to ISKCON temple, or there might be some. Yeah, I'll check on that. But now, we are not doing any personal, we will not sit and do. We will do it over Zoom meeting only. Like the way we are doing.
Not like that, Prabhuji. For darshan, we wanted to visit for that assistance.
Yes, yes, yes. I don't know, Prabhu, about that. No assistance required for darshan. So basically, what we are interested here is that on that day, on 25th, the way we are doing chanting, one person will lead of one round, next person, one more person, like that. All of us will be getting one chance in round robin to do one round of chanting. And but again, we will be listening to one person, but others will also be chanting. But unmute will happen as we do here, only one person, but it will be round robin. Okay, that is the plan. How many of you are thinking that it is possible for you to join? Is it possible? Yeah, same link we can use. Yes.
I will.
Yes, Supreme Mataji. Because we wanted to taste that taste of the holy name can come through association, through group chanting. So that is the reason.
Okay, Prabhuji.
Yeah, please join. Thank you, Matajis. Prabhuji, we'll see. We will definitely just keep it open for others. It is not a brainwash kind of a thing. Please do not misunderstand. This is ISKCON is no more not a brainwashing society. And if at all that brainwashing is happening, and it is for our good, that all the dust which got accumulated can be removed. So in one way, it is correct that brainwashing is happening for such that the dust can be removed. Okay. Thank you very much, Govardhan Prabhu. We'll end with Srila Prabhupada.
Yes. Yes, Prabhu. Yes, and before that, actually, Mataji, Sandha Mataji told to give some small announcement. After 24th, means after from 25th onwards, sevas are open for all. If you are interested to lead us in kirtan, chanting, and book reading, you can give your names to me or Mataji.
Yes.
We will assign that seva to you. And
ideally,
thank you, everyone, for joining me today.
Prabhuji, ideally, please, Prabhujis are not coming forward.
No?
Please. Prabhujis are not coming forward for sevas, so please get in touch with Govardhan Prabhu for any sevas that you wanted to do. And Mataji Sumana Sandha is already taking care, and please contact Sandha for any sevas Mataji can contact. So Prabhujis, please be active in taking up sevas. Matajis are always active, but Prabhujis also need little push. Yeah. Thank you, Prabhu. Govardhan Prabhu. Go ahead. Conclude, Prabhu. So we have taken a lot of time.
Thank you, Varandal, for joining in today's session. We have taken a little bit more time because an important topic was there. To cover that, we have taken a little bit more time. we have taken more time. And tomorrow at same time, we will meet at 7:30. Okay.
Right. Have any doubt? Krishna Prabhupada ki jai.
Jai.
Krishna Prabhupada ki jai.
Jai. Jai. Hari Bol.
Hari Bol.
Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.